The decision is, though, will they put some pressure on? Chenkins by himself, two eliminations. Teammates already down. This is a fight just outside of the new zone, so he's got a long rotate as well to make.
Humongous rotate for a lot of people. I'm going to be seeing possibly a lot of utility used for many different teams. Just only two get to save it. There is Chenkins with a drop down solo play. Three elims now. He's looking for, I think, eliminations being the only thing that can really keep him alive. Max mats, yes, but as soon as he gets pressured from a full trio, you will see what happens when you're a solo versus a squad. Hopefully, he will make that rotate. It looks free so far right now, but he has a huge hurdle to get through. Look at all these players in this big base.
Yeah, definitely the start of a monolith here. The builds are gonna start stacking up on top of one another. Jelly worked his way outside the edge of the zone line here. No, getting pressured, shot a few times from different directions here. The scramble is real. Where are your teammates? Where is Mac? Okay, Speedy 23, it's a big split. That's the problem with Shockwaves, especially since, we have this hybrid of season duos, trios. It's a lot different. Seems like he gets a knock here on Anonymous. That's huge for him.
Huge, but you were mentioning where his teammates. I think he's at the front portion of that tarp. With him being stopped, that's all the momentum for the whole team put to rest for the moment. Luckily, though, they do have a little bit of the side of where the zone is going to pull. Pulling back, they're on the left, that's good, but there's so many teams ahead of them. Just look at that mini-map. 44 people left alive on this six zone rotation. You do have that seven surge coming in as well. 14 people will need to go down in just two zones. I mean, this is looking jam-packed.
And there you have it. That one knock there was enough to definitely, you know, clear out the playing field a bit here and get himself to his teammates. And now they managed to huddle up together on high ground, though. Cat Daddy, Jake, and of course, Rocket Man here looking down on the competition right now. Soy Domo still up as well by himself. Chenkins still maneuvering this low ground here as well. Remember, he doesn't have any teammates now coming into this. I see Will Guo still alive right now in this low ground too. OTP and Devo still there. Everyone's on the move. Rift Fish, though, an extra in the inventory here for Fat Like Cheese, Ocho, and Strip. What an interesting way to use these. I feel like we haven't seen these in so long. It's really going to mix up the dynamic of the end game.
Yeah, this is like some Season 8, Season 7 vibes coming right back to hit us in the nostalgic feels. But got to remember, Shockwave's here too. That end game flashy play you can make as a team with a solo as well. When your mats are fizzled out, you have none more left to use down the line. Going back over though, the Jelly, Speedy, and Mackle. These guys had the best position for this zone to move. Where's the next one? Again, actually bouncing back to their old builds almost. It looks like no, they'll find a new journey and direction to move forward still in the center portion of the map. It looks like we're actually leaving, going towards some grassy lands as the zone continues to pull this way. But these guys are having some trouble on their tarp. A lot of action going down on the rotate.
Without a doubt here. Back with Speedy and Jelly right now. The good wide shot too. Jake still controls high ground with his duo, and they are setting up the anti-shockwave base design here. That's what you like to see. Let's see how this is gonna be able to play out here. Speedy putting the pressure in, and yes, they're gonna find a knock there and a full elim. Not only that, they will be able to pick up the full refresher there. Extra shields too for the road here now, so they will be able to conclude out and continue to rotate through. Sticking together as a squad now, elevates himself up, and they're big vibing here in the mid layer.
Dev have enough time to pop those shields as well to make sure going into this end game they're full on all resources to be able to deal damage and take damage as well, because with these packs, but there are no being one pump solutions towards every box fight, you will end up trading damage over and over again no matter what zone it is. So gotta be careful. Floor's already trying to be broken, but they end up securing it and are still staying secluded on their same lair. This is some great low ground type of action, but they're leaving the earth now. They're getting slightly more elevated. Don't want to be blocked off by any weird forming natural low ground. Still all sticking together, playing that placement. 12 trios up to live. That placement's trickling in as well. High flex, getting an elim in the feed. And here's another low ground trio we're watching. That's Titan, Flick, and Cascat. Also one layer up from that other low ground we just saw.
Yeah, and that low ground is dangerous. You saw how quickly those sand dunes can sneak up on you. That'll really choke you up in those low areas, especially if you run out of material. Gotta be careful down here. Three eliminations for this team already, and Mackle's gonna find one in the feed. Speedy finds another one there onto Will Gold, so already getting more and more. Here they go. Up for high ground they go, though. This is where the story changes now. It's Titan, Flick, and Cascat jockeying up for the height, and yes, he does control it. Their team is on height now. That is the prime position to be in as a full trio here and all your materials. Speedy, though, still looking for more fights now, looking to break into these walls. They're on the aggressive mid-layer push, and yes, they do. They find another knock now onto high flex, and they will be able to pick up that loot.
There's bodies falling from the sky. Strap and Oko go down, beamed off one of those rift fishes. Fact like cheese, no chance for him to be able to stay alive either. Speedy, Mackle, and Jelly are holding down. You were saying a new story on height, but the chapter of Midground has not finished just yet. These guys are looking so good, and they're a full team that's alive.
That's right, and this is a team that has some history here since competition days at the FNCS. Let's see, though. Speedy stepping through here. A little bit of a mistake as he was, you know, looking at his teammate. This is the pressure being up high. Working together, though, dropping down as a full team. They're going to run through the low ground, and yes, they find every elimination down there as well. Is the siphon going to be enough to keep them up, though? They're just barely inside the new Stormline. Mackle gets trusted out, and no, Jelly falls too. Speedy falls as well. Mackle gets beamed from high ground, and it's Titan, Flick, and Cascat who walk away with the victory royale. Oh my, takes a shot, doesn't hit it. That might be the end of him. We'll see if he ends up surviving that in just a bit here. On the other side, though, I hear Rift to Goes going off already from just under the Ops camera, and everyone else bouncing into the new zone line. Big names still alive here, though, are Mars, B-Hex there in the mid ground with a long tarp. Different type of rotate for them, though.
Very different on height. We have Steve and their true. We've been watching since the beginning of the game. Stay up top on ultimate height just for now. We know those Rift Fish and those Shockwaves are in place, so that could get a little bit more volatile as this zone continues to shrink over and over. Jake, though, picking up an Elim. DMA is going to be looking in a little bit of trouble on the health pool. Dip is already down. Him and Sage have to find something. Possibly it's not going to be there. Calamity is at hand, not only in the skin, but the damage too. He gets taken out, but Steve is still active on height. He takes out Mackle, our second place team.
That's right, but our Heat 1 Game 1 winners are still here. Titan, Flick, and Cascat. Remember, they had a substantial lead up. Now at 56 points, Rift to Goldfish is going to come out, and up they go. They drag a couple people with them, though. There's other players in the air. Yes, it's going to be shared by a multitude of players. And this is the play, right? You float. You stay up here. You try to buy yourself time. Look, players are getting dropped now. 14 duos remain. When are you going to take the dive? Here it is. They decide, okay, time to go down. They get right underneath high ground and actually play for the mids now. But the elevation on down, they want to continue to stick with one another. Who is calling the shots here? Either way, it's great plays right now. They're in the mid-ground layer, and they're looking comfortable.
This is literally deja vu, the same way they ended up winning game number one, controlling a higher mid ground there, taking out the height team with beams. Titan, oh my god, that heavy AR is hitting very heavily. Big shot, two healings back to back. Quick is there for the damage too. The pepper will be popped soon. We'll see these guys moving fast, lair to lair. There's a quick refresh coming in too for the materials that Flick needs so badly. There it is, 60 total mats now, four healings for this trio. This is looking like a repeat win.
And talk about the patience from Flick there to not just go and use all the chug splashes selfishly because his team didn't need it. He actually waited for the siphon pickup, and there it is. He gets the minis to go for it. Someone's going for high ground. Seven and Begs are going up. Mars is coming up as well. It's a battle for height. These are your biggest names right now in Heat 1, all going toe-to-toe now, and it's a fight on high ground. Flick, Cascat, and Titan, though, are just in the low here, letting everything else unfold. Fuzzy's still alive here. He finds a knock. Seven's going to find one as well. And all of a sudden now, Cascat, Flick, and Titan might be walking their way to a free victory here.
Man, Seven's getting E-limbs. Mars is there, too. He takes out Fuzzy McWhiskers, who had that height for the whole total game, but someone needs to stop Titan. These guys are letting the action just play around them. Already 5 points ahead in the lead and first on the leaderboards. They can get a second win back-to-back. B-Eggs now, also in trouble off of height. They don't have ultimate control anymore. Rocket Man's gone up and gotten some E-limbs. He got taken out by Homicidal. B-Eggs now, they're gonna play up for height. There it is, the E-limb on the kick. Easy pickings, but there still is his trio still alive in this endgame.
Yeah, definitely. They're still alive here, and they're operating all as a team now. Eight eliminations for the whole crew, and you can see the shots are coming down. The pressure's coming in. Maryland Esports Trading Academy, though, gets shockwaved out. And no, they're split, flying all out to the Stormline. That's a team that we didn't expect to make such a mistake, but now they're going to pay the price. They're going to pay the health price. And there it is. Titan somehow finds his way to new zone and gets the knock there, too. But it's Begs, Marks, and Seven. They have such an advantage now off of that one single misplay there.
That misplay was so crucial for these guys to be able to maintain their height. It's good for them so far. On the last mat, though, is B-Hex. These guys have to be able to do something now. They have no mats left, which is what it looks like. This will have to be a three-man drop-down play. It starts. There's B-Hex on the actual front side, and he lands the shot onto Rhino, stopping the animal in his tracks and gaining that victory royale.
And there you guys have it. One of our most consistent teams take the victory royale there for game two of Heat number one. That was Universe.